we are not angel. Some people blame us because
tell us what your mistakes are. Tell us what your big mistakes are.
Some people blame us because we participated in the election. They asked us, like Mr. Muhammad Hassan al-Hekel, leave the administration for the others and keep your resistance against the Israeli. That was good from the ideological, from philosophical point.
You're still not telling me what your big mistakes are. What are Hamas's big mistakes? You're perfect.
If we got the majority of the Palestinian people, I think it was a mistake. When we run a real purified administration, it can be considered from the other as a mistake.
All right.
Give me one mistake. I'm asking everybody to give us one example about mistake. But we are not an angel.
Okay, lady in the fourth row.
Do you believe everything you've achieved so far is worthwhile, even though many lives have been lost along the way, including the lives of your sons?
I lost two of my sons. And the two trials, air raid to kill me personally. And I lost my son. He was about 23 years. And the second one was 21 years. And you can imagine how, when the father looked to the chest of his son, and he see his chest is empty, is not working, and it is burned by a tank bomb. And you can imagine a father who was unable to build a grave for his son because of the absence of cement. And you can imagine a father and a mother and other people who are unable to cover the grave of his son. That is the crime of Israel and the crime of America, and that is, I'm very proud about what my people did.
Okay, gentlemen in the first row, please.
Dr. Zahar, I read a report that the Palestinian television company, I don't know what it's called, but in the kids' shows, they're actually encouraging kids to have one cause in their life, and that is to demolish Israel and also to kill Danes and Scandinavians for the Muhammad cartoons.
This is the one eye policy published by the American and by the pro-American people. All the time they are concentrating about what happened in the Arabic television, and nobody
is true. Is it true or not?
I will tell you what is happening in the schools of Israel. They are speaking about their land.
We're asking about the schools in the Palestinian territories.
Give me a chance.
And you always push the question onto what is going on in Israel. We're asking you about the Palestinian television.
You can suppose for me.
Can you give a direct answer to a direct question?
I am answering the question very, very clearly.
In a very roundabout way, Dr. Zahar.
That's
in a very roundabout way.
Okay, that's
please my... Please stick to the question.
That's my style.
I know it's your style. I know it's your style. Please answer the question.
There is incitement inside Israel, reach it to the level that we are snakes. Rabbi Yusuf, Avadi Yusuf, he is a part in the government. He described Muslims are snakes and the scorpion.
You want to come back?
And nobody is commenting about that.
Let the questioner come back. Excuse me, Dr. Zahar, let the questioner come back.
So you're encouraging, you're saying that it's justified that your children are encouraged to actually be indoctrined to murder Israelis?
No, this confession can be, you can use it for the Israeli in order to criticize Hamas. We are not encouraging anybody to commit any crime, any innocent people, but we have to differentiate between Jews and occupation. When Jews dismissed from Britain 1290 and from France 1302 and when Spain 1492, the only place for the Jews were the Islamic land. But we are speaking here about people came, replaced our people. 6 million Palestinian people are living in exile.
Dr. Zahar, you've gone back to 1492. It was a question about what is going on Palestinian television. It wasn't about 1492.
It was one event, and the official people asked them, don't do it again. So you can make a survey about our study about our television, and I think, to be fair, also you are in need to see the other television in the Israeli side, what they are addressing for their own people.
All right, Jim. I'd like to have somebody from the Palestinian territories. Lady at the back.
How do you consider yourself an Islamic organization when Islam forbids killing civilians and innocent people, even if they were your enemy?
We are committed to Islam, and we are very proud to be committed to Islam, because this is the only moral basis that we can use it without diversion from the true faith and even from correction. We have to differentiate between crimes committed against us. We have to protect ourselves, to protect our project, which is representing the majority. But we are not putting Islam as a sword on the